But you said, I will certainly make you prosper, and will make your descendants like the sand of the seashore, too numerous to count. The book of Genesis, chapter 32, verse 12. When Jacob was on the other side of the brook Jabbok, and Esau was coming with armed men, he earnestly sought God's protection. And as a master reason, he pleaded, and you said, I will surely do you good. Oh, what a force in that plea. He was holding God to his word. You said. The attribute of God's faithfulness is a splendid horn of the altar to lay hold upon. But the promise which has in it the attribute and something more is yet of a mightier hold. You said, I will surely do you good. And as he has said, shall he not do? Let God be true and every man a liar. Shall he not be true? Shall he not keep his word? Shall not every word that comes from his lips stand fast and be fulfilled? Solomon, at the ceremony of the opening of the temple, used this same mighty plea. He pleaded with God to remember the word he had spoken to his father David, and to bless that place. When a man gives a promissory note, his honour is engaged. He signs his hand, and he must discharge it when the time comes due, or else he will lose his credit. It shall never be said that God dishonours his bills. The credit of the Most High is unimpeachable and always will be. He is punctual to the moment. He is never before his time, but he is also never behind it. His timing is always perfection. Search God's word and compare it with the experience of God's people, and you will find the two agree from the very first to the last. Many a patriarch has said with Joshua, not one thing has failed of all the good things which the Lord your God spoke concerning you. All have come to pass. If you have a divine promise, you need not plead it with an if. You may urge it with a certainty. The Lord meant to fulfill the promise, or he would not have given it. God does not give us his words merely to shut us up, and to keep us hopeful for a while with the intention of putting us off at last. But when he speaks, it is because he means to do as he has said. Amen.